Hello everyone, in this video we have one triangle and here is alpha, here is 2 alpha and this angle is 60 plus alpha and then these two parts are equal, alpha is asked. Okay, first of all, if we create an isosceles triangle, here must be 2 alpha and these two sides must be equal, right? Okay, and this triangle is also an isosceles triangle, so this part must be equal to others. Okay, and then if we move this triangle to the left side, like this, here is this angle is alpha and this angle is alpha, so 60 degrees left here, and then these two triangles are congruent, therefore these two sides must be equal. Okay, and then if we connect these two points, notice that we get an equilateral triangle. Let's call here P point. PDB triangle is an equilateral triangle. Right? Okay. So these angles must be 60 degrees and we know that two interior angles equals one exterior angles. So here this angle must be 3 alpha minus 60 degrees. And this triangle is an isosceles triangle. Therefore, here must be 3 alpha minus 60 degrees. Okay. Finally, we know that in a triangle, sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees. Therefore, three alpha minus 60 degrees plus alpha plus here 60 plus alpha plus 2 alpha and alpha equals 180 degrees. Therefore 3, 4, 5 and 8 alpha equals 180 degrees. So alpha is going to be 45 over 2 degrees. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate value of alpha using sine rule for second method. Okay. First step, let's call these equal sides A unit and this side I'm going to call here B. You know that two interior angles equals one exterior angle, so this angle must be 3 alpha. And then, according to sine rule, for this triangle, B over sine here, but we can calculate sine 3 alpha instead of sine CBD angle because sines of supplementary angles are equal. So A over B equals sine 2 alpha over sine 3 alpha, right? This is the first equation. Okay. And then, if you focus on the biggest triangle, this angle here, I am going to call theta. Therefore, for ADC triangle, if we apply sine rule, P over sine theta equal A over sine alpha, right? Okay. We know that sine theta equal sine 60 plus 4 alpha, right? Because sines of the supplementary angles are equal. That means we can calculate sine 60 plus 4 alpha instead of sine theta. Okay. P over sine 60 plus 4 alpha equal A over sine alpha. Therefore, this equation that's right here, A over B equal sine alpha over sine 60 plus 4 alpha. Okay, this is the second equation as well. Therefore, if we equalize these two equations, because these are equal, so sine 2 alpha over sine 3 alpha equal sine alpha over sine 60 plus 4 alpha. And then we can calculate 2 times sine alpha times cosine alpha instead of sine 2 alpha, right? Let's remind you, sine 2 alpha equal 2 times sine alpha times cosine alpha. Okay. Sine 3 alpha equal sine alpha over sine 60 plus 4 alpha. If we simplify the equations, these are again. Therefore, 2 times cosine alpha over sine 3 alpha equal 1 over sine 60 plus 4 alpha. Okay. If you multiply with sine 30 both of the equations, result will not change. So sine 30 times 2 times cosine alpha over sine 3 alpha equal sine 30 over sine 60 plus 4 alpha. So let's simplify, because sine 30 equals 1 over 2. Therefore, cosine alpha over sine 3 alpha equal, we can calculate sine 150 instead of sine 30, right? Over sine 60 plus 4 alpha. And then, if we organize the equations, sine 60 plus 4 alpha over sine 3 alpha equal sine 150 over cosine alpha. Okay. Therefore, 60 plus 4 alpha must be equal 180. Therefore, alpha is going to be 45 over 2 degrees. If you plug in this value into the equation, the result will be correct. Okay, thanks for watching.